Don't you try and bluff me. I've dealt with your sort before.
You might like to think so.
There's one thing I can't stand. It's a crooked officer. And I won't have one in my prison.
You're forgetting something, Murphy. This isn't your prison. Wentworth is mine. And it's gonna stay that way. A dead rat. Because of you, I copped an extra 6 charges.
You lay off me. Myra and Jude will get you.
Oh, funny. I don't see them around. And I reckon when they do find you, they'll put the blame on Murphy. Or the freak. Get me out of here, will you?
You perverted bitches are all the same. I was picking on the young girls. I can't stand dykes.
Can't take the competition, can you?
Said you wanted to see me urgently. Anne, what is it?
It isn't over.
What?
They've arrested the wrong man.
But Neville Sloan admitted... Oh, you must get Inspector Russ.
He's on his way.
You die like this rat. They didn't send you a... Oh, my God.
He's still out there, Meg.
Great bloody watchdog you turned out to be. I've just rescued Marlene from Kelly. What the hell do you think you were doing?
I'm sorry, Myra.
Yeah, well, sorry's not good enough, Jude. That kid could have been history by now. I've given Bobbie the job. Hopefully she won't bungle it.
Has it ever occurred to you that I might need some protection too? I was looking after her. I only lost her because I was talking to you. I went after her, but I ran straight into Murphy.
Oh, Jude.
He gave me a working over. He sure knows his stuff.
Shrewd, too. I see you didn't touch your face.
No, he just broke my stomach. Sadistic bastard.
I'm sorry, love. I should have realized something was wrong. Don't worry. Murphy will get his.
Yeah, that'd be right, wouldn't it? An eye for an eye. If they won't come down to your level, then just give them more bashings and bashings. I'm sick of everyone being frightened in here, wondering who's going to be the next victim. I've had it, Myra.
Yeah, well, so have I, Jude. Don't you see I'm trying to stamp it out?
Well, if you are doing a rotten job. There are 2 people here today that can prove that. When are you going to be a real top dog and get some control here?
Quit sniveling, will you? You're breathing, aren't you? Serves you right for giving Jude the slip.
Yeah, well, I couldn't help it. I can't go when someone's standing
on... Well, you'll just have to learn, won't you? Try giving me the slip and I'll let you drown.
Okay. Last way I want to cark it anyway.
She can't be 2 heads in the loo at the same time, so you just have to stick with me.
Well, that's a cosy little scene. Okay, Warren, on your feet.
What do you want it for, Miss Ferguson?
That Mitchell is my business.
If you lay a finger on her, I'll tell the governor.
Really, Mitchell? And what would you tell the governor? That I object to this place being a pigsty? Now, Warren, you might like to live in filth, but it's my job to see that government property is kept in order, Now, clean it up. And if it's not spotless when I get back in a few minutes, there'll be yet another charge, insubordination.
Of course, the ideal situation would be to keep you here, in isolation.
No, I am sick of being scared. I want him caught and locked away for good.
I know that, but I can't risk your safety.
And I cannot spend the rest of my life in protective custody. I can't go on like this.
Well, surely there must be some way to get a lead on him. I mean, he sent in all these letters and parcels unobserved.
I'm aware of that. We were following a possible lead, but that Neville Sloan idiot and his admission got us sidetracked.
So you lock up the wrong man and let the guilty one slip by?
It was nothing definite. It was just a hunch I was following. You know, possible grudge motives, and we came up with a few names.
Well, who were they?
Oh, the Parker family, the Bakers, Thompson and Lowe. Personally, I'm interested in this Lowe character. He was Phyllis Hunt's boyfriend, you know?
No. Not visited here.
That's because he was in prison, but he was released a few months ago. Now, we know he visited Phyllis in hospital once, but since then we've lost track of him.
But why would he do this to me? I didn't put Hunt into the asylum.
No, no, of course you didn't. But you were in charge, though. We've questioned his mother and all his known past associates. There's nothing. We've checked all his old usual hangouts. In fact, he seems to have done a complete vanishing act.
Well, he's still out there somewhere.
Mrs. Reynolds, I understand how you feel. It's only a matter of time before we get a lead.
And it's only a matter of time before my sanity runs out.
Now, please, try to be patient. Yeah, all right. I think it'd be better if we were to move you into motel for the time being. It'd be easier to stake out.
Oh, that means she'd be alone.
No. No, a policewoman would be rostered to be with her at all times, plus surveillance on the room.
No. Look, why don't you stake out my place? Anne could stay with me. It'd be a lot safer and a lot less obvious.
No, Meg, thank you for the thought, but
I'd be a lot happier if you did stay at Mrs. Morris's.
Right, all right. Anything you say, just as long as this maniac is caught.
Geez, Auntie Raby's really excelled himself tonight with the tucker. I reckon I could have got another round.
You and me both. Freak worked up an appetite, eh?
Yeah, well, cleaning up her mess is only half your fun. Now you got the charge to come.
Oh, Reb, we're trying to cheer Marlene up, not depress her.
Yeah, sorry.
Well, Marlene, what you need is something to take your mind off your problems.
A bit hard with Murphy still lurking around.
Well, remember one thing, there's safety in numbers.
Well, I just wish she'd get it over and done with. I mean, like, Lou's had a go at me and the freak. I just have to wait for him.
Yeah, well, you make sure you're with someone all the time, and that's an order. He's not going to settle for just a charge.
Yeah. Come on, Marlene, cheer up. If you like, I'll do the Bible quotations with you.
Don't reckon I'm going to make a fortune that way, Pix. We're going to have to come up with something new.
A few things to get straight, Kelly. I warned you to stay away from Warren, but you didn't listen, did you?
Ow!
What's this?
Lover's tiff. Stupid bastard couldn't shoot straight.
You've got a knack for exciting people's tempers, haven't you? Now, a few things have changed around here since you left.
Oh!
I don't repeat myself for a start. Now, you lay one finger on anyone in this prison and you'll end up in Blackmore before
you... Okay, keep your shirt on. I settled with Warren.
Yeah, you've settled with everyone. Now, it's us versus the freak and Murphy. There'll be no infighting. You hear me now?
Yeah, that's good, Mrs. Morris. There's undercover men stationed outside and your policewoman will be arriving tomorrow morning. Now, if anything worries you, anything, you phone me straight away.
No worries, Inspector, I will.
This isn't fair on you, Philip.
Please, look, I told you I have nothing better to do tonight, and besides, I want to help.
Now, with bars on all the windows, his only access will be through the front door.
I'll be fine, unless the hostess here decides to throw me out.
Oh, leave us unprotected? Never.
Good, that's settled then.
Good. It's not good. How many nights am I going to have to spend like this?
Well, I can't say. Just try to relax and forget about it.
Yeah, how about a drink?
I'd better not. I'm still on duty. Now remember, phone me at any time.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night all.
I'm sorry about today. My little blow-up must have been the last thing in the world you needed.
Forget it. Then Murphy tends to rub people up the wrong way. But please try and be tolerant. He's new and over-energetic at the moment.
Yeah, I know. Look, I'll stay clear of him for a while.
Well, as long as there's no more talk about leaving Wentworth, you're definitely needed.
Oh, thanks.
Well, what's to be? A night at the telly?
Charades?
Well, they can say it's an accident. I don't believe it.
Neither do I. Shame we had to find out this way, isn't it? Reno knew how we felt about Karen. She should have told us about him.
Poor Lyle. He mustn't have been able to face the thought of life without her.
Yeah, well, you were the one who said they were like Romeo and Juliet.
Well, that's what makes it all the more tragic. I mean, they'd still be alive and in love if it wasn't for this place. They only wanted to be together.
Well, look at it this way. We're together now.
Yeah. Pixie's right, though. It's a bloody shame. Karen should never have been here in the first place.
Sounds like me.
Much and all, I hate to admit it, Callie, for once the authorities were right.
Oh, next you'll be telling us Higgins is okay.
Yeah, that bitch has got to be straightened out.
No one touches her.
Why? You're letting her walk around here like she owns the place. Bloody stuck-up bitch should be suffering.
Yeah, well, she is, isn't she? We've frozen her
up. Oh, bullshit is. I'm in here an extra year because of her. And what about the rest of you? Exactly. We all copped extra time.
Yeah, she gave me an extra 18 rotten months.
I say we teach her a lesson.
Do that and you defeat the purpose.
That's right. If you bash her, you're the ones that end up with extra time.
Yeah, she'd lag for sure.
For the few extra months we'd cop, it'd be worth it.
No bashings, Callie, and that's final.
Oh, you're piss weak.
Look, we deal with Higgins in time, but we do it my way and with no violence. Understood?
What are you doing here? Lost Dog's home's next door.
Got some news about that business deal I was talking about.
Yeah?
My mother's visiting tomorrow. I'll be setting up the financial arrangements.
Just visiting, is she? I could arrange to have her back in here permanently, if you like.
I doubt it.
I might surprise you. What's her freedom worth? 10? 20 grand?
Not a chance.
You're forgetting about me little flesh wound. And about that copper that saw me at her place. I could have her back in here before a trial even comes up.
What do you want?
Not that much. Say, half the takings? Takings, not the profits.
You want to go 50-50 on the takings? You do half the work.
Yeah, I like to protect my interests.
It's a deal.
Just a minute. I haven't finished yet. You watch it, Kelly.
I said it's a deal.
Had a little taste of your lifestyle while I was out. Reckon I could hack it real well. I want 10 grand deposited in the bank. Get Deirdre to fix it.
Long time before you're going to get the use of 10 grand, isn't it, Lou?
Well, I could put it in one of them interest-making accounts. Then when I get out, I'll be doing it in style.
Shh.
Anne's asleep. You don't want to wake her now.
Oh, sorry, she must be exhausted. Yeah, I don't know how she manages to cope with everything that's going on around here.
I know. I have the greatest admiration for that lady.
It shows. Hey, look, about tomorrow night.
Oh, do you mind if I call it off? I mean, I would love to meet your parents, but I just feel that Anne needs a friend at the time like this.
You know she'll protest. Besides, she'll have a policewoman with her. Look, a party'd be the best thing in the world for you. Look, I promise I'll have you home early. Hey. There is life after Wentworth.
I know there is.
Am I that hard to cope with?
Not at all.
Murphy's heading this way.
God, what am I gonna do?
Stay calm. I'm here, aren't I? You'll be all right.
Oh, yeah, you saw the way he looked at me in the rec room. He's gonna kill me or something. It's not lock-up time yet. Maybe I can hide somewhere.
Why, it's too easy if he catches you in the corridor.
Where's Warren?
I don't know. I haven't seen her.
I like to see loyalty amongst cellmates. I hope Warren appreciates you lying for her.
She went to the loo. She said she'd be back in a sec.
Oh, what a shame. Looks like she's going to be late for lock-up. I'll have to put her on a charge.
But it's not time for lock-up yet.
Oh, my watch says it is. Sleep well, Mitchell.
Morning, Myra. Mrs. M. Everything all right?
Madam Higgins is still breathing, isn't she?
Yes, but that isn't what I was asking, though.
I'm fine, thanks, Mrs. M.
Right, ladies, keep it moving.
Doesn't look too good to me. Must hurt like hell, eh?
Putting the cold wash on it helped, though.
Yeah, but it didn't take the swelling down. Your eyes are going black. Reckon you'll have a couple of shiners by lunchtime.
Do you think anyone will notice?
Anyone not colourblind will. You're gonna have to report it.
Are you kidding? What if no one believes me? Then he'll really try and get me and he'll probably kill me next time.
All right, ladies, come on, move up.
What happened to you, Warren? Your face looks a mess.
Hurt myself. How did that happen?
Her nose looks broken to me.
Must have been sleepwalking. Woke up when I banged into the wall.
Well, I said she needed a padded cell.
Righto, Kelly Jenkins, that's enough. Keep moving.
Come on, Warren. What really did happen?
True, Mrs. M. She woke up screaming near the wall and there was blood and everything.
All right then, Mitchell, you go on to the showers. I'll take Warren to see Sister Hall.
Oh, Marie. If you don't fix those nose jobs fast, they could wreck a girl's appearance. Couldn't let that happen.
Morning.
Good morning, Miss Ferguson.
No, we're formal today. What's wrong?
Oh, I didn't get much sleep last night.
Oh? Thought you might have been stewing over that takeover bit of Murphy's. Mind you, I wouldn't blame you. I was a bit put out myself.
It's got nothing to do with Murphy. I know I got a bit riled yesterday, but that was then.
Oh, you had good reason. I think he's trying to nudge you out. He's not too fond of social workers. You see, he's made it rather obvious that he thinks they're all a bunch of do-gooders. Personally, I think you're doing an excellent job.
Thanks.
Of course, if you'd care to make a formal complaint, I'd be happy to back you.
Look, I really don't think that's necessary, but thanks again for your support.
No thanks required. I'd just hate to see a dedicated young man like yourself pushed out. You know that Murphy's made it quite clear that he wants the governor's job. And if that happens, you'll be out.
Look, I hardly think that's likely. I can't see Mrs. Reynolds handing her job over to him. But apart from that, I can take care of myself and my job.
Glad to hear it. Well, I've got to get Warren back from the infirmary. Someone gave her a facial and she's too scared to say who. I guess there'll be quite a bit of that happening around here from now on.
And Sister Hall thinks it's broken. She sent for the doctor.
But I don't understand why she didn't call for an officer. It must have been painful.
I know. And you don't get a broken nose through walking into a wall either. But Marlene is sticking to that story.
Come in.
You sent for me, Governor?
Yes, we're concerned about Warren's injury. Do you know how it happened?
No, I don't. It's dreadful. She was all right when I locked her in last night, kidding away the same as usual. And then when I saw her this morning, gave me quite a shock. How could anyone do anything like that to a nice kid like Warren?
But didn't anyone hear when it happened?
Well, there was nothing to hear. A few snores here and there, but certainly no screams, not while I was on patrol.
Well, someone's got to her.
Well, Mitchell's a cellmate, but I can't imagine Bobbie doing that to a friend. And I locked them in last night, so I don't see how any of the other women could have got to her.
They couldn't.
You know, I don't like to say this, really, but... Have you thought of questioning Miss Ferguson? She was on duty. I mean, there's a lot of pressure on officers in prison. You need a pretty level head to cope with some of the provocation you get from certain prisoners.
Thank you, Mr. Murphy. I won't keep you any longer.
Certainly, Mrs. Reynolds.
What do you think?
So much for your safety in numbers, pep talk. Didn't make any difference, did it?
Look, Marlene would have ended up with more than a broken nose if Bobbie hadn't been with her.
Yeah, that's right. Murphy has made his first mistake.
What?
There's a witness to the bashing.
Oh, come on. We all know he had it in for Marlene because of the betting scandal. Now, he had motive and opportunity, and for once, we've got someone to back up the story.
Hang on a minute.
Yeah, look, I don't know, Myra. I reckon he'll get out of it somehow. It's like when I took on the freak. I nearly died. What happened to her, sweet F.A.?
Yeah, but this is different. It was after lockup. Now, the only one of us that could have done it is Bobbie, and she's got no battle scars. So Reno has to believe it's either Murphy or the freak. Now, with Bobbie backing up Marlene's story, it's goodbye Murphy. No, I think you're expecting too much. I mean, it's hard enough for you and I to handle it, let alone a couple of youngsters. Oh, God, look, I'd do it myself, but it wouldn't make any difference because I wasn't there. When are we going to get another chance, like...
Hey, Kelly, Governor wants to see you. No need to stop work. Have you seen black eyes before?
Was it broken or what?
Nah, Sister Hall said it's just really badly sprained.
Sprained? Who ever heard of a sprained nose?
Must hurt. Why are you smiling?
Because he's finished with me now. They've all had their go at me, I reckon I can rest easy.
Look, Rabbit, we've been having a talk and we think you should come clean with Reno, with Bobbie to back you up.
Oh, no way, Jose.
Oh, come on. When are we going to get another opportunity like this?
I don't care, mate. I fronted about Murphy before and where did it get me? Might be gutless, but I'm not stupid.
Yeah, well, I don't blame you.
Me either. I don't want any part of it.
Great. That's the way you want it. But don't any of you come running to me for help.
With this new evidence, you've been cleared of the murder charge, but you'll still have to stand trial for the extortion and blackmail charges.
I told you I had nothing to do with killing that cop, but we're never believed, are we?
You've got no one but yourself to blame for that.
But I was innocent, and now I'll cop extra time for trying to escape. All because no one had listened to me.
Just be quiet, Kelly. You'll find yourself on another charge.
All right, that's all I had to tell you. Will you wait outside for a moment, please?
If this is about the charge on Warren and Mitchell, I can assure you their cell was a disgrace.
No, it's got nothing to do with that, Miss Ferguson. We've got something more urgent to discuss.
What's that you're doing? Catching up on a bit of office work, eh?
No, I'm working out how we can keep up with the softball practice without overlapping with your handyman courses.
Actually, the ladies prefer a handy person. But it's good for them. Teaches them practical things. Not that I'd expect you to agree. You'd rather play games with them, wouldn't you?
Look, I think they need physical as well as practical recreation.
Look, at my age and experience, I don't expect any Johnny-come-lately yank to tell me how to run prisons or what the inmates need.
Mr. Listen. Cleary, I would like a word in private with Mr. Murphy, if you don't mind.
Be my guest.
I have just had a fascinating talk with the governor.
Oh? What about?
Warren, you bastard, Murphy. How dare you insinuate I had anything to do with her injuries?
Oh, that. Yeah, well, I thought it was fair game. I had a little chat with Lou Kelly yesterday. She told me about how you were going to set me up. So I took the liberty of getting in first.
I've dealt with slime like you before, Murphy. You won't win.
Listen, Ferguson, I've told you before. I play it straight down the line in every way. Queers like you are chicken feed. Now, why don't you bow out gracefully before I really get vicious?
You creep.
She still doesn't like me. That's why she won't sit with me.
Will you stop imagining things? You'll give yourself the blues. Myra's angry with all of us. Why take it personally?
Yeah, that's right. Besides, you've got plenty to look forward to. Reno could get in touch with your old lady any day now. It's pretty special.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying not to bore everybody by talking about it all the time. Do you know what it's like trying to find a mother you never knew you had?
I can make an educated guess. Look, if you're finished, I'll take that for you.
Thank you. She's really nice when you get to know her, isn't she?
Well, a week ago, I would have said no. I guess people can change.
What do you want? Picked up the murder charge against me. So I'm going to be out of here faster than I thought. Make sure your old lady's got the money ready for me.
Kean, there's a visitor waiting for you.
Righto.
I'll take her through to the security gate.
What's the panic? Still got five apiece to go, if we're lucky.
Come on, Kean, hurry up.
Coming right now, Miss Ferguson.
Well, anyway, there I was fixing the tea tray for Mrs. Reynolds and Ray told me all about it. I mean, I don't know exactly how she did it, but Ray said Reb could really make things difficult for him, but she fixed Miss Ferguson instead, so he doesn't have to worry about either of them. Isn't that incredible?
Yeah, she's pretty cluey, I reckon.
Maybe
yeah.
She could fix it so the freak could stay off all while
back. Yeah, maybe. It didn't work last time. Then again, she didn't have mates to back her up, did she?
Hey, can I join you? I hate to drink alone, huh?
Hey, where's Sam going?
Oh, I'm going to go and talk to Crystal Cleary, see if she can get some art stuff sent in.
I'm really worried about her, you know.
Why, painting can't hurt anybody.
Painting? Oh, no, silly, not Sam, Myra. She looks so worried.
Yeah, life's tough at the top.
Yeah, it is. And maybe she thinks we'll toe the line more if she gives us a bit of space.
Yeah, well, I reckon she's up herself.
Oh, don't be awful, Marlene. After all, she did save you from Lou. Heavens, I wouldn't want all that responsibility. I think we should get together and let her know we're on her side instead of squabbling all the time.
Leave it to that one to hit the nail on the head, huh?
Well,
Oh, I'm sorry, Jude, but my nose is the one that got flattened and it bloody hurt.
You look so sad over here on your own. Do you mind if I join you?
Fred, I'm not much company, Pixie. I don't feel like talking.
Oh, well, don't worry. I'll just talk twice as fast and you won't have to answer.
Oh, Pixie, funny if it was that simple.
Oh, you're not still blaming yourself over Karen's death, are you?
Oh, partly. I don't know, I just feel I could have done something to avoid it.
Myra, you're top dog, you're not God.
Thanks, love. Wish the other women believed that, especially over this Murphy business.
Well, I'll help you, I promise.
Yeah, I know you will. But I've got to sort this one out myself. Starting right now.
Gone completely off its head. I mean, where are we supposed to put them?
Isolation, I suppose. There's nowhere else.
But it says an indefinite stay. I take it they are making special arrangements for their security.
No, it's being added to our workload. They don't see any problem as long as we keep it from the women.
Oh, come on. We tried that with Sarah Higgins and look what happened.
I know, but at least the media isn't on this one. And Colby himself's going to supervise the induction.
Oh, how very comforting. I'm sorry. Should be supporting you, not arguing.
Sorry to interrupt. Desmond's here. She says it's important.
All right, Pat, you're in.
Desmond?
Mrs. Reynolds, could I see you alone? Nothing personal, Mrs. M. Now then, Myra, what's the problem? I think there's something you should know. Warren can be a pain in the bum sometimes, but she is not a sleepwalker.
You're saying she was bashed. In that case, why didn't she report it?
Because she's too bloody frightened.
Was this bashing connected with money that changed hands yesterday?
Of course it was.
I want a name, Myra.
Mrs. Reynolds, we are talking about two officers. How much clearer do I have to be? Now, no one is going to come out and finger a screw. I can't do it because I wasn't there. The kids won't do it because they're scared of retaliation.
Without a name, what do you expect me to do?
I expect you to figure it out and get rid of the person responsible. I could do it. But the department would have to put me on salary. If I'm going to do your job for you, I want to get paid.
That'll be all, Desmond.
Yeah, but it's really confusing. I mean, I keep wanting to put salt in with the washing or starch in with the carrots. Or why can't they leave us in one place all the time?
You don't think they're going to do anything that's going to make any sense now, do you?
Yeah, that would confuse us all.
Fair enough. When do we get it?
When they get the money. Just cool it, will you?
Well, what do you know? A truck with a busted nose.
Get out. I have to get to the dryer.
I reckon you ought to keep that bandage. Hide your face.
Cut it out, Lou. Just leave her alone.
Slag out!
Cut it out!
Now, when someone tells you to cut it out, you listen. Got it?
Okay, I heard you.
That's better.
See? Just what Ray said.
Yeah, I reckon we need someone who's more action than talk.
Yeah. Problems?
Yeah, sort of. But I wouldn't worry yourself about them. They've been taken care of.
And that's all I can tell you at the moment, I'm afraid. Pat and Meg will be staying an extra hour to get isolation ready.
Well, it's not going to be easy, Mrs. Reynolds, if the press get wind of this.
It's up to us to see they don't, Len. I'm counting on everyone's cooperation.
Fair enough. It's going to mean tightening up the security on the women, though.
Yes, well, there's no use pussyfooting around. We need extra security measures, otherwise all hell's going to break loose around here.
I'm well aware of what we need, Miss Ferguson.
I only meant... Never mind. There's nothing else.
As a matter of fact, there is. We're all aware of the problems of the past few weeks. Contraband is one thing, but when prisoners are being bashed, we've got a real problem, and I don't like it.
None of us do, Mrs. Reynolds. But if the women won't confide in us...
They won't confide in us because someone in this room is doing it.
Oh, I see. That old chestnut again, eh?
Did whoever it was who reported this mention any names?
The fact that the officer is still here means I haven't got enough evidence for dismissal. But I want to make one thing clear. I will not tolerate abuse of the system. If anyone sees a fellow officer bullying or badgering a prisoner, they are to report it to me immediately.
And if we do?
Then it's up to me.
I tell you what, we
Who cares? Anyway, we won. Red really clinched it for us.
Yeah, on you, Reb. Good one.
Cut it out and make me blush.
We have more time. We really could have thrashed them, eh?
Hey, I've got a great idea, Jude. Why don't you make up a theme song for the Wentworth Red Sox?
Oh, come on. That's stretching it a bit much, isn't it?
No, it'd be really ace and you could put in a line about cannonball, Keen.
You won me. Come on.
All hail the conquering hero.
Meaning?
Kean's suddenly very popular.
She hit a home run, why shouldn't they cheer her on? Besides, she's trying to make amends, not that I would expect you to understand.
I never looked on you as a stupid person, Myra. But if you can't see what's happening, then I've obviously misjudged you.
Now listen, madam, I'm getting...
Can I have a word, please, ladies?
Any news, Mrs. Morris?
No, there's no news, Greenway. But I do have to tell you there will be an early curfew tonight.
Oh, what?
How early is early?
Lock-up will be at 8 o'clock.
Why? We've been punished.
Yeah, we haven't done anything.
It is not a punishment. It's a security measure. Hopefully only for tonight.
Security like hell. What's going on, Mrs. M?
I'm sorry, I can't tell you.
I can or won't.
We've got a right to know. Either you tell us or we lodge a complaint with the department.
I'm sorry, it's not up to me. Department's orders. 8 o'clock.
Well, maybe it's a surprise and they're organising something special they don't want us to find out.
Oh, yeah, we'll just see them doing us a favour.
I would have thought it was obvious. They're bringing someone in. Someone they don't want you to see.
Oh, I hate to admit this. She makes sense.
Yeah. Explains why they moved the rubbish out of isolation.
Golly, well, it must be somebody really important if they're going to all this trouble.
I thought you'd be halfway home by now.
Don't worry, I'm going now. The squad car's outside. I really wonder if I should have stayed there.
Why? If Colby thinks he can handle it, who are we to argue? I'll be home later to change.
Good. Glad you're going to the party.
Well, actually, I'd prefer to stay at home with you.
Don't be silly. You're just nervous about meeting Philip's parents. Or you're still worried about leaving me at home?
Mm-hmm.
Well, don't be. I'll be perfectly all right, and I certainly won't be alone.
You sure you're all right? You're looking very tired.
Oh, I'm fine. Except I could do without Joan on the rampage to add to my troubles.
Do you think she beshed Warren?
I don't know what to think anymore, but I intend to find out. See you at home.
Bye.
Mind if I come in?
Oh, sure. I was just writing a letter to Cass. I know it won't do any good, but I can't give up on her yet.
Yeah. Jude, we don't seem to talk much anymore.
Maybe that's because we always end up arguing and I don't want to fight with you.
Yeah, same here. I've been to see Reno.
To Dodd Murphy in?
Well, I didn't name names. I couldn't. I mean, I wasn't there and without the kids to back me. It's all right, don't worry. She knows it's either Murphy or the freak. She's just got to sort out which one. I'm sick and tired of doing her job for her.
Myra, I don't want you to take this the wrong way, but I don't think that you can fix everything yourself. You're not God, you know.
You're the second person that said that to me today. Do you really think I'm playing God?
No, but I think you're letting things get to you. I know that most of it's probably my fault. I haven't been backing you, but I can't do things your way. Now, Reb, she seems to have changed. Couldn't she help you deal with Murphy and the freak?
And then I stand aside and let her take over as top dog, right?
No, I don't mean it that way. She'd just support you. She has come up with some good ideas, you know.
Yeah, you're right. I was thinking of using one of them, actually, to improve my image. Her suggestion for Sarah.
Oh, the kangaroo court.
Yeah. Got to do it properly to satisfy the women and make sure Sarah doesn't get hurt.
Yeah, you could give some good punishments to her, too. Toilet duty, fetching and carrying.
Anything, as long as it relieves the tension around here.
You see, it's a good idea. It's worth a try.
Hey, I just got to convince the women of it.
Yeah, but be careful. Murphy's in the rec room with the women at the moment, giving one of his classes.
Thanks.
Hang on a tick. I reckon if I just smooth over this bit of wire, it should be all right. Where's the soldering iron?
Right here.
Kids your age shouldn't play with fire.
Get knotted, Lou.
Hey, that'll do, that'll do. Warren, what are you doing over there? You won't see anything from there.
Oh, no, I can got a great view. I can see everything. Just...
No, come over here and stand next to me. Don't worry, I won't bite you. I think we understand each other now, don't we?
Reckon that's just about got it.
I'll plug it in for you.
Oh, thanks.
Good work, Mitchell.
Well, what do you know? She did something useful for a change.
Whose is it anyway?
Mine.
Jeez, thanks, Squirt. Bloody known, I'd never have bloody fixed it.
Hey, you know, you've got a feeling for this sort of thing.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Murphy.
With a bit of professional training, you'd make a fine Sparks.
What's a Sparks?
That's a nickname for an electrician.
What do you know? Sparky.
Sparky!
Sergeant Duncan and Anne seem to be getting on like a house on fire.
Yeah, Jenny's a great girl. Darn good cop, too. Any idea what time you're getting back, Mrs. Morris?
Probably around midnight, if not earlier. I've got work tomorrow.
Right.
I'll see you.
Good night.
Bang, bang. You're dead, copper.
Your show.
It's going to be pretty hard to recognise him from a 10-year-old mugshot.
Who's this over here?
I've seen a red setter wandering around, have you? Pulled the bloody lead right out of me hand, stupid animal.
Ah, sorry, mate.
Thanks anyway.
Joy's alive in the suburbs, eh?
No, don't knock it, mate.
See the blokes in a couple of hours, all right?
Yeah, be back about 10. Right. Try and stay awake.
Penny!
Crap, and it was giving me a headache.
It is not crap. Did anybody see this?
Come on, baby. No, we're playing cards.
What was it, Marlene?
Only the best, the most stupendous money-making idea of all time. You ready for this?
Oh, yeah, go on.
Frog racing.
Oh, you pull the other one.
No, no, I'm serious. It's in America. It's really good. You all have your own frogs and you bet heaps.
And I suppose you're going to paint your legs green and end it right. You're built for it.
Oh, shut up, Lou.
Look, we can all make some money.
And where are we going to find frogs around Wentworth, eh?
Oh, the grounds are full of them. Only I thought they were Bunny Brown's relatives.
Oh, but it wouldn't hurt them, would it? I mean, they are God's creatures, you know.
Of course not, Pixie. I couldn't hurt a fly.
You'd have to feed the frogs.
Could be a lot of fun, Marlene. You might have trouble finding the frogs, though.
Oh, I don't know. I reckon there's one in Rabbit's bed some night, especially if we had baked beans for tea.
It's one thing not to be able to get an intelligent conversation around here, but I do expect some peace and quiet to read without being subjected to foul gutter humour.
Up! Oh. Watch out for the frogs.
I think it's time she was brought down a peg or two.
Yeah. There must be some way to fix it. There's several. How about burning her at the stake?
Oh, no, they do that to witches.
Right word, wrong spelling.
It's okay, Pixie. No one's going to get hurt. I think that idea of yours, Reb, about the kangaroo court, that should sort her out. Make her answer our charges. I'll be the judge and hand down the punishment if she's guilty.
We don't need a trial to tell us that.
Are you with me or not?
Yeah, can you think of something better?
Yeah, I reckon it's a good one.
Yeah, well, I want to prosecute. I've been up before her more times than anyone in here.
Fair enough. Bobby, she went easy on you. Do you want to defend her?
Do I have to? She nearly bit me head off when I tried to thank her. Mm. My heart wouldn't be in it.
Well, we all feel like that, love.
Oh, but someone has to defend her. I mean, it wouldn't be fair a trial otherwise, would it?
Quite right, Pixie. How about you?
What?
Yeah, well, look, we all trust you, don't we? You'd give her a fair go.
Yeah. Oh, golly, I've never been a lawyer before.
Okay, that's settled then. You can all be the jury with Judy as chairman. What do you think, Kelly?
I think it stinks, but I haven't got much choice, have I?
No.
Okay, girls, for the early night, some of you could use the beauty sleep. Back to yourselves, come on.
Yes, can't wait.
So what's it going to be?
Tomorrow night, sooner the better.
And I couldn't quite see myself in an office or behind a shop counter. I guess I joined the force looking for excitement, but it took me a while to realise that this is just plain hard work.
I know it.
Oh, Meg, I nearly jumped out of my skin.
Give us a little bit more warning next time, will you?
Sorry. You're back early and told me the party was as boring as that.
No, that wasn't boring.
I just acted like an idiot, that's all.
I'll make some fresh coffee for all of us.
You and Philip have a row?
No.
Well, yes. Oh, it was my fault. His parents were charming, food was lovely, and then somebody started to talk about child abuse, and that led to sexual abuse, Chris and Phil tried to change the subject, but I just couldn't cope. I walked out. Oh, I'm sure Philip would understand. Oh, he did. Came down to the car and gently tried to point out that I'd have to learn to cope with that sort of thing. But I just shouted at him, called him names, told him he didn't have any feelings. Oh. Yeah, I know. I overreacted. And then all the way home, I just kept saying to myself, you fool. You really care for this man and you're always driving him away. Oh, honestly, Anne, I wouldn't blame him if he gave me up as a lost cause.
Coffee?
Well, I don't know what to say in this letter. There's so many questions.
Will you help me write it, Jude?
Yeah, sure, love, but I think you should speak to Mrs. Reynolds tomorrow about it.
Oh, God, not already. It's in early.
Can you hear that?
Yeah.
Help me move this table over, quick.
All right, get him inside as quickly and quietly as possible.
Do you see anything?
Nah, just shadows. I can't make out who's who.
Hey, Myra, there's a crowd out there. Any idea, Myra?
Careful of that stretcher. We don't want another accident.
Not a bloody clue. There's a mob of them, though.
God, is that all it is? It's going to be a long bloody night.
Yeah, they don't get too many good-looking sorts around here, do they?
You don't hear too much of anything. At least that guy with the dog broke the monotony.
Speak of the devil.
Quick, wind up the window, otherwise...
Hey, mate, excuse me.
Sorry, mate, haven't seen him.
Really, my boyfriend's so stubborn. I'm always the one that has to ring him after an argument.
Perhaps I should ring him.
Who is it?
Rutledge, Rouse.
Don't make a bloke feel very welcome, Mrs. Reynolds.
I don't know why you're doing this, but don't hurt Meg. She's no part of this.
Bull. She's another bloody screw. She might come in handy later. Okay, ladies. We're going on a little trip.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are Christmas too. When morning comes around.